Now that we have an idea of the basic structure of a Java method, there is something which is important yet difficult for beginners to understand. This topic has to do with what is happening inside the memory space of a running Java application. I am trying to make this course as practical as possible, but in this case, the theory is a necessary component of what happens in practice. A common interview question for Java developers is as follows: does Java pass method arguments by value or reference? It is important to understand that even using the word reference here confuses the issue. In any case, if you just look at the code itself without knowing what goes on under the hood, it is reasonable to assume that we are passing references between methods. However, the correct answer to this common interview question is that Java passes arguments of any type by value. In order to explain why all variables, whether they are reference or primitive type, are passed between methods by value, we will look at a quick example in the debugger. Before that though, if for some reason you have skipped ahead and not watched the lesson in section 2 about what primitive and reference types are, go back and watch that now. In this class, I have created two member variables, one which is a primitive type and one which is a reference type. Again, this particular example does not practically solve any problems. I am just showing you about how the methods deal with variables. Within the constructor of this class, we call these two functions, printInt and printString, passing in our member variables. Note that because we are directly assigning these variables within the body of the class, they will already be created before the constructor is called. Let us use the debugger to see what the memory space looks like when we call these functions. At this point, we have not yet called printInt, but we see that primitive var and reference var exist in memory space. After proceeding to the next breakpoint, which is in the printInt method, we see that a new variable has been created and its value is 1. However, if I click on the This tab, which represents the memory space of this class, which contains our member variables, we see that primitive var and reference var still exist. So the point is, even though it looks like we pass primitive var into printInt from the constructor and it pops up in the printInt method, what shows up in printInt is a different variable which has the same value copied to it. If things are still confusing, let's change the name of the parameter and look again. See? New variable with the same value. Pass by value. Reference variables work in much the same way, it's just that the value they copy to the parameter in the receiving method is itself an address in memory. As you can see here, once again we have two distinct variables, but notice that the address in virtual memory, which is what follows the @, remains the same. Again, let us change the names to avoid confusion. Different name, but the same address value. Pass by value.